Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Heike and you're watching Stone Cold Coffee Crafts. My little furry assistant Lola the Ragdoll Cat is with me. She actually has her own camera now. My neighbor is very fond of power tools today. It is 10 a.m. now and he has been on it since 7:45 this morning. We are all three not very impressed. You might hear Nelly in the background. She is so cranky because of this. So I apologize in advance. There will be power tools, there will be cranky cats, there will be all the disturbances. It looks like this is just what today is going to be, but I had planned to film this today and I have to do it because otherwise I just will keep not doing it for weeks and weeks, because this was actually supposed to be my last video of 2022. And today is January 9th of 2023, so that's how that went. Anyway, this is both a Flosstube episode and my end of year, beginning of new year whip parade. It is not going to be much of a Flosstube because, hi, you have your own camera. You don't need to come into mine. She's like, I don't care. Because I don't have a whole lot of Flosstube things to tell you. I have not kept track of my acquisitions. I have literally one finish I want to show here because I don't think I have shown it on video before. And just to preserve it forever and ever, or for how long YouTube exists. And then it's going to be all whip parade. Spoiler alert, I have, I think it was 11, 6, 9, 10, yeah, 11 whips, so it's not totally over the top. It's nearly double as many as I had at the beginning of 2022. But yeah, that's live Tina. So, my one and only finish I am going to show you today is one that I finished in October of 2022. And it is my Mirabilia Cathedral Woods Goddess. I started her in October of 2020. She was my October high team new start. And then I didn't touch her for the longest time. And finally decided to work on her last October. And I didn't just work on her, I finished her. So as always, it is a bit hard for me to show her in her full glory because I don't do the be in camera on hold up thing, and I think I should have positioned my camera a bit better. It is way too far to the left, so I'm sabotaging myself. Excuse me while I fiddle with my setup live on video like a pro. Anyway, I think I also need to adjust the Lola setup a little bit because she's taking up way more space than she needs to, especially since she isn't even here. So, Cathedral Woods Goddess was my first Mirabilia. She also was... I think that's a lie. No, she's not my first fancy lady I started. I started her 1 month after Dark Queen of the Sea. So she's my second fancy lady, and she is just gorgeous. I mean, look at her. That whole dress down here, so pretty. She had a lot of krynek, she had a lot of beads, and she had a lot of silk. So she was very, very fun to stitch up. I did a lot of her on stream. I actually did a whole beading stream. Because she had like 1500 beads or something like that. And I know a lot of people are curious about beading and how difficult it is. Not difficult at all. So yeah, she was fun to work on. The fabric she is on is a 28 count Winter Sunset, I think the color was called, by a dyer who is no longer dyeing, Crafty Kitten in the UK. This was a fabric I searched high and low for about a year, and I was so happy when I finally found it. It fits perfectly. She was stitched with all of the called for flosses. I just switched out one of the krynecks. So there was one krynek that was called, I think, Vatican Gold. And it was not the usual krynek, it was like a rope. And that stuff, it was horrible to knit, to stitch with. So I switched it out for, it's this lighter gold color here in the leaves. I hope you can see there are two golds. Get off her. There are two golds, and the lighter one is a petite treasure braid. I think actually called light gold. I'm not entirely sure. I was also supposed to use it up here in the crown or in the antlers, but I actually used a silver krynek that I had gotten for the Dark Queen of the Sea, and I think I bought the wrong color. I'm not sure. It might have been that I bought the wrong color. I know I bought one wrong color. So basically I messed up all the krynek on the Dark Queen. There wasn't so much, so that wasn't too bad. So it's two different colors here. Both should have been the same gold, but in the end I decided the difference isn't distinctive enough that you can actually see. If you don't know, you know now, so you probably see that this is lighter than this. But it was fine. And then she had a poop ton of beads, which was so much fun because I personally love beading. Also a couple of treasures, a couple of bicones, but nothing too wild. Mainly it was just standard beads. Yeah, so that was my last finish I had. Since then I have not finished any of my cross stitches unless I'm completely forgetting something. Oh my god, this guy goes, he's so going on my nerves. I think it's actually the business downstairs. They have switched owners and they might have started reconstruction. It is just so fucking annoying. Pardon my French. Especially because they started so early this morning. And it was one of the rare nights I actually was able to sleep, so I'm a bit salty. So the whips I'm going to show you are in no particular order. I just grabbed them and stacked them here, so we will just go through them how they are here. So my first one, give me a second. Okay, we are back. So the first one, kitty, go in your bed. You are in the way. The first one is my next fancy lady. It is the Mirabilia Miss Christmas Eve. The fabric blows out really bad. It's a real gold fabric, another fabric I searched for such a long time. Finally found it at Babarol Creation in Hungary. It is called Old Gold and it is a 28 count opalescent linen. I have tried so many gold linens from so many different dyers and nothing really was really the color of gold, but this was perfect. Even though it doesn't show up like it on screen, you have to trust me, it is the perfect golden linen. 28 count opalescent because that's just how I roll. I like my sparkly fabrics. And I started her just recently in December and literally only stitched her for 2 days. And the third day I had to basically rip out completely. So yeah, I put her in a timeout after that. So she has not been worked on since mid of December, I think. Both the needle minders you can see here are from an Etsy shop called Hobby Wishes. I will try and remember to link everything down below, but she was linked in my Vlogmas videos, so if I forget, you can go back there. I think it's one of the last few videos where she was linked in. Yeah. So this hasn't gotten much love yet, but I'm expecting to stitch much more on her this year because I really enjoy stitching on the Mirabilias. I just have to pay a little more attention and not make stupid mistakes and then have to rip back like 300 stitches. That would be much preferred. I am so bad at these filming video things right now. So, am I forgetting something? Stitched with all the called for, I have not switched out anything. She doesn't have any Krynek, if I remember correctly. Yeah, she doesn't have any Krynek. She has like three silks, but no Krynek, so there was nothing to swap out. I might in the future keep swapping out Krynek, just FYI, in case you're interested. That is the first one. Let's just not bury myself in stuff and creating a craft lounge. So this is another one that I started fairly recently. This is what I call my ghost sampler by Cute Patterns by Maria on Etsy. She released, I think it was six ghosts. Yeah, I think it's six ghosts. And she released them as separate patterns and as a pack. I got the pack of all of them and I decided to stitch them like a sampler. And also because I still have quite a few pieces of Ada, but I haven't used them in a couple of years, I also made the conscious decision to use some Ada for this. So this is an 18 count Ada. It is by Chromatic Alchemy. Again, opalescent because I have so much opalescent fabric. And the color is called Abyss. I don't think. I just checked her webpage, but I don't remember seeing it there. So I don't think that Abyss is a regular color for us. So I'm afraid you probably won't be able to get it. And I chose to position the whole thing. It is not centered. I decided to position it a little to the left because I wanted to catch these lighter spots here, because that half over here doesn't have the lighter spots. So there's like one more going here, and then there's a whole lot of fabric left over here. So it's not perfectly centered. But if it's enough fabric to do something with it, which I don't think it is, I will. If not, oh well. We have an overabundance of fabric in this house, so I don't have to be stingy. The whole thing is stitched with all the called for, I think, except for the white. I think for the white, I went with Silks For You white silk, because I tend to switch out white with silk since I am not a big fan of stitching with white or 5200 or whatever DMC. Usually, I feel like my crosses look really wonky when I do. But this is a lot of fun. Cute Patterns by Maria. She has so many really adorable patterns. This is one of the easy ones. It doesn't have any blends. It doesn't have any partial stitching. So it is extremely easy. And I feel like I have to pick this up soon. This week is Friday the 13th, so I'm going to have a dark 13 stitching stream over at Twitch. But I think I'm going to work on my other Halloween project for that, which will come up in like 4, I think, if I see the fabric correctly, 4 frames. Yeah, this is a lot of fun. I would like to finish this year. Yeah. I think I would like to have a finish on this year, because these stitch up very quickly. I think it took me like 2 days to get through the point where this is, because it's color blocky, it's not difficult, and also stitched on Ada, the counting is even easier than on other fabrics. That being said, full disclosure, I am one of the lucky people who does not have any issues counting on fabric. No matter which fabric, no matter if it's opalescent or not, actually the fabric that gives me the most difficulty is Lugana, which people always find very funny, but it is true. It is too even for my eyes. But yeah, that is my ghost sampler by Cute Patterns by Maria. And I'm trying not to make this video like hours long. So let's see. So this is the one I'm currently working on. This is Sparkling Spring by Owl Forest Embroidery. I picked this up on a whim on Friday because I wanted something to stitch on stream and I had finished this month's drop of the Dark Queen of the Sea, so I decided to pick this one up. And I have finished this motif and also this part of the corner motif so far. This is a complete kit by Owl Forest. It came with everything needed and also a needle minder on top here. And yeah, I'm stitching it just as it's charted, except this is the first time I changed something on an Owl Forest. I'm so sorry for the power tool. The birds were supposed to be in more of a brown tan color, which was very close to the fabric and didn't look good at all. It looked very drab, so I decided to use the yellow that came with the kit for other stuff. And also, you can't see the whole thing, but I feel like the yellow makes the whole thing more balanced because everything looked very balanced except for the corner piece up here because it had the brown birds instead of the yellow birds. There's some yellow going on pretty much everywhere. So I feel like that balances it in the end as well. I started this last year in spring. My plan for 2022 was to finish, I have all four of the seasonal samplers, to finish each sampler within the season. So I stitched winter in January. And I started spring afterwards, but I fell off the Owl Forest wagon. And I don't know if it is because of what was going on at the time and I didn't feel comfortable stitching on a kit from a Russian company, even though that company has no fault whatsoever in what is going on over there. But yeah, I just fell off the wagon. So I picked it up now. I want to finish this within springtime or by the time spring is here, we will see. This is currently at like 27%. So still some way to go. And I can show you the center. You're probably interested in seeing the center because these samplers have a little bit of a special feature, as in the center has special stitching. Can we move? Is that something we can accomplish? Something is going on with this particular frame. And I'm not fond with it. It is very not stable. It is wonky and not doing what it's supposed to do. So maybe I need to switch it out. It is not rolling as it's supposed to. Why are you? So this is the center, and I'm going to get a bit closer to the camera so you can see. It has some special stitching. All four of them have special stitching in the center, and it's always different. So the outer frame is always the same, just different colors, but what's going on in the inside is different for each seasonal sampler. So for this one, I learned a few new stitches I had never done before. I really need to check what's going on with this frame. This is driving me nuts. I've noticed it while stitching that I can't tension it completely like I would like to. And that drives me absolutely crazy. Cat, off the table or on the table? If on the table, bad. she is so cranky because of the noise that's going on all morning. Yeah, so this is a Sparkling Spring, stitched like called for, except for the birds in the upper left corner, which I made yellow, and those birds now look so much better. This is, like every Owl Forest, just such a pleasure to stitch. So yeah, plan is to finish it this year. And I'm leaving it wonky as it is now because I want to retension it perfectly. I smell failure. Next up is another big one, and I cannot show you this one completely because she is too big to fit in my frame, but it is the Dark Queen of the Earth, the second big year-long stitch along by Autumn Lane Stitchery. Dark Queen of the Sea was the first She ran from September 2020 to August 2021, and in September 2022, Autumn Lane released her sister, the Dark Queen of the Earth, and I am caught up. This month was drop 5, so in February we are already halfway through, and I am caught up. So this month was this side of her, this bit of greenery and wood and thorny, not tentacle, vine. Yeah, she is absolutely gorgeous. Unlike the Dark Queen of the Sea, where we knew pretty early on what her face looked like, she still doesn't have a face. We went down first and stitched the bottom, which is a lot of stitching, but doesn't it look fantastic? It is a bit more doom and gloom on camera than it actually is in real life, but she is, that's a feature. So she is supposed to be very doomy gloomy. I am stitching her on a 28 count opalescent linen, again by Barbaroll Creations. The color is called Thunder. It looks very blue purple on camera. It is actually a bit more on the pinky red purple side of things, and it has these golden splashes here, which also blow out on camera. But I thought it would fit her perfectly because there is no purple in the called for flosses, and I like to have my fabric as a big contrast to whatever I'm stitching on it. So the called for fabric, there were two. The one was green and the other one was brown, but the whole color palette, with a few exceptions, is basically green and brown. So I didn't feel like I wanted that. And I think I made a good choice because it stands out perfectly, but it is not garish. So I like it a whole lot. A whole lot. Also, my fabric is very moody, so I think it fits her perfectly. My needle minder here is from Agnes Little Minders on Etsy. I had a second one on this piece. It was this one here, but I lost the backside of it in the living room and still haven't found it. So there's that. Yeah, nothing much to say. Stitching it with all the called for floss, it is amazing. Each drop is giant because Erin just hates us. Well, that being said, this month's drop was only, and I'm saying that with air quotes, only 2,570 stitches. So I guess for Erin that's a small one. And now I'm waiting with bated breath for February. I am thinking we're going to finish whatever is going on here. I don't know if she's going to have legs. I kind of don't think so. Yeah, but whatever, there is something going on here stitch-wise, and I guess that we are going up and it's time for the upper body, the face, the magic, whatever is going on up there. Erin already said that there is going to be once again a little bit of a stitch your own adventure thing going on in the upper half, like with the Dark Queen of the Sea. So looking forward to that very much. I just love these ladies. But once she is done, I finally need to do my Miss Sakura. Also from Autumn Lane Stitchery, she is kitted up. I have fabric for her. I just have to start her and finish her before the next stitch along, because I'm pretty sure there will be a next one. These two have been so successful, I can't imagine that he won't do another one. Ah, cat. I have to pick up stuff from the floor again once I'm done. Yeah, I have to finish that one because these are so amazing. They are also very big, so I have to decide where to put them once they are framed, because the frames are giant. I'm guessing probably the bedroom, because that's the only room where I have the wall space for them. Which sad, because then no one can see them except for me and my boyfriend. But anyway, so that is, which one is this? Is this number 4? I think that is number 4. Yeah, that's number 4. Dark Queen of the Earth by Autumn Lane Stitchery. Can you please just stop? Next one could be my oldest whip. I don't know for sure. I probably should have opened up the frame as well. Because you can't see anything this way, but I can. Unroll it up here and just so this is the wedding sampler by Long Dark Samplers called Forevermore, I think, or Evermore. I have no idea because my brain is basically not working. Forevermore was correct. Okay. So by Long Dark Sampler, this is one of their smaller pieces. It is only a 4-page pattern. I have finished the upper two pages and I'm working now on the third one down here. I think I'm about halfway done with that page, I believe. I'm stitching it with Silks for You Silk, basically in an ecru colorway, so that's where that button page is, and this is stitched on a 28 count opalescent linen, one of a kind, by hand dyed by Rolanda on Etsy. And yeah, this is actually fun to stitch, but I have learned over this small monochromatic sampler, and I think that's the main reason I picked a small one, that I am not a huge fan of stitching on monochromatic stuff. So I don't see myself doing it a whole lot in the future, even though I enjoy Long Dark patterns quite a bit. I like Julia's humor and the quirky little details she puts into all of her samplers. I'm just not really... I don't stick with it for long, and that makes a piece like a typical Long Dark sampler like a 10-year commitment. So, I don't know. I'm not the person to do stuff like that. That's why I don't do a lot of full coverage. But anyway, needleminder, I made this one myself. This wax seal came with an order from a company I prefer not to talk about because they have a huge affiliation with an IP that I don't talk about any longer. So it's a bit awkward. But yeah, it was on that order. I liked it. I turned it into a needle minder by putting a magnet on it, and now I'm using it because it's cute. But yeah, I think this is my oldest whip, and I really, really, really would like to finish it this year. I doubt I will. I might get one of these little pushes of energy to work on it like I did last year, and I managed to crank out about a page and a little bit, I think, worth of stitching, but I don't know if I can actually finish it. I mean, it's like a page and a half, maybe a page and two-thirds left on this. It should be not that hard, but it's just not keeping my attention, this monochromatic stitching. That being said, I love stitching with the silk. I love the color. I love stitching on this blue fabric. It is perfect. And yeah, it is my passive aggressive message to my boyfriend of 22 plus years that maybe we could change the status to something else but boyfriend and girlfriend. Not going to happen, I'm afraid. So next up is my second Halloween project, and that is the Toil and Trouble by Plum Street Sampler. Thank you, Cat Samplers. I am, as you can see, color completing on this, and I have so far only worked on the black, which is some fancy floss, and I think this is all gentle art, no exception whatsoever, the whole color palette. So I don't know exactly what this color is called without pulling it out, but yeah, black. Also, I hate stitching words, so doing the words first is always a goal of mine. There's a stitch with all the called for fancy floss on 40 count vintage pear linen by Lakeside Linens, and that was an adventure to get back in the day. I bought this at the beginning of the pandemic, and I was lucky that the lovely ladies at Traditional Stitches in Canada were able to get this fabric for me, but it was not fun. So whenever Lakeside Linens is now mentioned as the called for fabric, I am not even trying to get the fabric. Like, what do I have too much time in my life? No. So and you can't even see it on camera. It is not gray. It is a weird poopy light green tone. Very crunchy, very Halloweeny. So there's that. Needleminder was made by I've forgotten how her channel is called now. It used to be Dutch Dog Diamond Painting, but she renamed her channel. I'm so sorry. I completely forgot. I completely forgot what your channel name is now. I'm so sorry, but she sent it to me a couple of Christmases ago, I think, for Christmas. So I'm using it usually for my Halloween pieces because it fits. It's little kitties. So yeah, I think that is the piece I'm going to work on Friday on my stream for Dark 13 because I haven't stitched on this for a while and I actually love it. It is very simple. It is an early Plum Street sampler. I think it's from 2008. It is very different to her more recent designs, and I'm really looking forward to. There are a lot of trees in the background, and each tree is one color just to fill in. So I'm going to stitch all the outlines, and then the fill-in is going to be some movie stitching because it's brainless. I love it. But the fact that it's all fancy floss will make it not boring. It means I have to stitch every cross on its own, but I'm okay with that. That's how I started out stitching, so I'm okay with that. Yeah, so that is Toil and Trouble by Plum Street Samplers. Oh my god. So, my one and only full coverage. And look how much I got done on this so far. This is Iron Cat by Gecko Rouge. The artist is Jenny Parks. You can see nothing, so I'll try to remember to put a picture in. This is ridiculous. I don't like the idea of full coverage stitching. It is just not my jam, and so far I have resisted very hard. I started this because I am a huge Avengers, MCU movie and Iron Man fan, especially. And when I saw the cat versions of it, Jenny Parks turns pretty much everything into cats. I just had to have him. And I really would love to like full coverage because I would like to get the big one, the one with all six original Avengers and do the big one. But I have to stitch on this more, and I actually have to convince myself that I like this. So if I remember correctly, this is 28 count Lugana that I picked up. Magic Grid by Zweigart. It is not the fabric the kit came with. The kit came with the DMC pre-gridded fabric, but that stuff is so awful. It's just horrible. So I did not want to stitch on that fabric. I got this, and I liked this better for the 200 stitches or so I did. I think it's not even 200. And I'm stitching a 10 stitch. Or I am going to stitch a 10 stitch because I have learned that I am not doing it right the way I have done it so far. And it might turn my fabric weird if I keep this up. So I have to look up how to properly do 10 stitch on the back. not just half stitch. And yeah, at some point I will pick this up and work on it. Maybe I can make it a goal for August, because August is Pogost. But I don't know. Full coverage is just not something that tickles my fancy. My fancy ladies are as full coverage as I can stomach. So there's that. This was a new start last year in April, in May. I did not do what was it called now? Because they said we are not going to call it Mania anymore for obvious reasons, so they gave it a new name. But actually, we renamed the whole thing because none of my friends actually did that last year. We did, at least Rachel and I did, we did these sprint streams where we stitched on each of our whips for a certain time. And we called that Maestravaganza, and I didn't just stitch on all my whips, I also had a couple of new starts, and this was one of them, because back at the time I think I had 6 whips. So one of my new starts was Iron Cat, and my other new start is coming up next. So the second new start I had during Maestravaganza was my rainbow, my twisted rainbow sampler by Northern Expressions. Look at my brain keeping this all together. This is stitched on a 28 count linen called Stygian, like the river Styg, I think is what the name came from. This is once again by Chromatic Alchemy, but this is once again not a fabric she has in her regular catalog, so you can't get it. But there are other fabrics that are very close and look just as good. It is like a black with a dark teal splash in it, so it's very nice, and I think it will make the beautiful rainbow color silks. Why are you giving me the murder face, cat? Can you see that one eye? It is peering straight at me. It will let the rainbow colors shine beautifully. This is also just what I put in on stream when I did the new start, and I haven't touched it since. It is also wonky on the frame, so I don't like it. I probably have to reposition it. But yeah, I think this is going to be amazing. I'm stitching it with the Dinky Dye Silks. The official conversion, I think it is. I think it was not charted for Dinky Dyes, but she put in a conversion, and that's what I got. And Needle Minder by my friend Rachel Ray. So not very impressive, but there's that. Next one is one that needs to be finished this year. I do not want to see her on my frames any longer. It is, and I'm sorry for the yellow frame, that's my camera picking up on the face. It is Natural Beauty number 3, I think it's called, by Philanthrop. It is a kit. I bought it as a kit. The fabric is a Jobelin. I think it is a 28 count Jobelin, and it comes with this printed on background. And part of it is stitched and part of it is going to be the background. And I'm actually mostly done with her face, so I have a lot of hair left to do and some of her neck and stuff, but I got a lot of progress done on her. She still needs her backstitching. I haven't done any of the backstitching, so her eyes will pop a little more once that is done. But I don't enjoy the process very much, and I can't even tell you why, because she is beautiful. But yeah, this year I think she is going to be my project for February for Black History Month, because that's only what I started her for. And I thought I would finish her. It was last year I started her, and I was on a real stitchy roll at the beginning of the year, and I thought, yeah, that would be easy. It's not the biggest project I have, It would be easy to start and finish in a month if I do stitch on her monogamously. And then I didn't. Look at me and my plans. But yeah, I think I'm going to pick her up again this year for February. And this year she needs to be finished. Because I need to have the finished product. I'm stitching her as she came. The kit came with Aurifil floss, which is more like a sewing thread, and I'm not enjoying it. But it's also not easy to convert it to DMC. There aren't always good color equivalents. So there's that. Yeah, not my favorite project, but I hope that it will be one of my favorite pieces once it's done, because it's just so pretty. It's also the reason why I have not gotten the other kits. They have released two more. This was the first, even though it is called number three. It was the first they released, and they have now released the other two. But I don't think I'm going to get them, even though they are pretty, because I do not enjoy stitching on these. Second to last one, so number 10, another Plum Street samplers, and this is my stacked animal sampler. I started the fox together with Jesse and Rachel. We wanted to do the same pattern and see how we progressed through it, the differences between our ways of stitching, because we noticed that we are very different in the way we stitch stuff, so we decided to do that. And because I can never just do one little thing, I decided, well, this is going to be the centerpiece of a big stacked animal sampler, because I love these animal samplers. So far I have done the foxes and the hedgehogs. This one here will be the raccoons. So I should get back and work on those. This is basically what I did in May, and that's the last time I touched it. But yeah, these are fun, and I like that Paulette is still releasing some of them. Makes me rethink my plans quite a bit. Also makes me a bit sad that I didn't know there were more to come, because I think I could have put them a little bit more over to the left to fit a fourth one in here, and then it could have been a 12 stack sampler. Now it's going to be a 9 stack. This is a Fortnite fabric, a 36 count linen, and it is from the Mushroom fabric of the month they did in 2020, but I don't remember which one on top of my head, and I don't have the project back with me. But anyway, it is the fabric of the month, so you can not buy it anyway. It has this reddish tinge. It blows out quite a bit on camera. Bit of a red terracotta thing going on, which is not my favorite, but I thought it fit the animal stacks quite well. And so far I'm liking it. Liking it very much. So this is my last on the frame. Needleminder came from an Owl Forest kit. I think this was from the Baba Yaga kit, because this is Baba Yaga's hut. It has two needles, so I probably should repurpose one of the needles on some of my other pieces. I always keep searching for needles. But this is a lot of fun to stitch, and these cute little patterns usually take me like 2 to 3 days. So I don't know why I'm not further with them. I usually stitch them with all the called for floss. I think I only switched... Yeah, I switched out the color for the flowers here, because they were supposed to be white. And I thought this would be extremely boring. The whole hedgehog pattern didn't have a whole lot of color. So this is an Owl Forest color. I remember that much, but I don't remember what it's called. It's from Owl Forest Embroidery, this corally pink. And that's the only change I made. Everything else is as called for. Mostly fancy floss, if I remember correctly, on this one. This was stitched in a lot of DMC, so I think the only fancy floss called for was the green. And I think the rest was DMC. So it seems like that these patterns are getting a bit more budget friendly now. In the beginning they were really fancy flossy, which I love. I will always go for the fancy floss if I can. But now they are getting a bit more budget friendly, which I think is also a good thing. One thing I am not super fond of, these frames, they are all black, and I don't know why. One pattern calls for, I think it's Weeks Dye Works Coal, and the next one calls for Onyx by Gentle Arts, I think it was, or it might have been the other way around. I just know it calls for different blacks from different companies. I think one is actually just DMC. I think the Hedgehogs were just DMC black. What it called for, and everything looks a bit different. I don't think you can actually see it on camera, but looking at the sampler itself, it is sadly obvious that each frame is different. So I think from now on, all the frames will be stitched in 310, no matter what the pattern calls for, because it's stupid. But that being said, that's my only gripe with these patterns. I enjoy working on them a lot. And last but not least is a project I can't tell you too much about, because this is not my half of it, just the half I have to work on. And this is... Ooh, don't show the pattern. You smartest person in the world. This is the Friendship Sampler by Michelle Bendy Stitchy Designs and the Blue Flower. Janine from the Blue Flower. And this is something that my friend Rachel Ray and I decided to stitch on and work half of it ourselves and half of it for the other one. So this is Rachel's sampler. And she has finished her upper half. She used a ginormous piece of fabric for this. And sadly, she also oriented it in the landscape way, so I have no idea how to get this on my frames. It is too wide for that, and I don't have Q-snaps or stuff like this, because I don't like working with those. I have to figure out how to work on this. I probably have to get out the frame that I bought specifically for my shuttle-in and just use that for the time being. Yeah, but that's her upper half. I know that this fabric is Barbaral Creations, and I think... Is it Americana? The color might be called Americana. It looks very gray on camera. It's actually more of a mauve. But I think that's what it is, and it might be a 40 count if I remember correctly. It might be a 40 count. It's mostly the called for flosses, but she has switched out three of the colors for fiber. Is it Fiberlicious? No. Oh, I think she has switched out more colors. There's a Fiberlicious purple in here, which is not called for, and then these, yeah, it's also Fiberlicious Silks. There's the third one. But I think the other colors are called for. So the ones that are not called for in the patterns are these four, I think. I don't have my own sampler because she has it right now. So I can't show you next to each other, but her colors are a bit more vibrant, the ones she has switched out here for the silk. So the green, the pink, and the dark blue is actually not very dominant in this part. I think there's more in the second part to come. So I have to find a way to get this on a frame and work on this, because I would like to send it back to her before Stitch North in May. I think that would be a good time to have this done. But yeah, she worked on this when she was here in April of 2020. We worked on this together while binge watching Lord of the Rings, so good memories. And this is a beautiful project. If you have a stitchy friend, I highly recommend to do it this way, to stitch half of it yourself and have your friend stitch half of it. It's going to be fun, especially because Rachel and I stitch opposite to each other, the way we cross our axes. So I think it's a very interesting piece to have, and it's a great touch to see something that was not just stitched by yourself or just stitched by another person, but basically a collaborative project. There's a tiny piece of silk here. So yeah, that's my last whip, even so I have not worked on it yet, but I need to figure out how to get this on a frame. This is a giant piece of fabric. This is a fat quarter. Oh my god. So yeah, this is going to be also something I need to work on soonish. Yeah, and that's it. That's all my current whips. That was my whip parade, end of year, beginning of year, whatever you want to call it. I think we kept it under an hour. I'm so proud. I guess most of them I would like to see finished this year. I know that I can't finish the Iron Cat, and probably not the whole Twisted Rainbow Sampler, because that is also very involved and has barely been started. But there are a few I would like to see gone by the end of the year for sure. That's it. I promised the whip parade. I have at least filmed it, so I hope I will get it also edited and uploaded now. Fingers crossed. If you've seen this, I obviously have. I hope you had a good end of last year, a good New Year's Day, and may this year be filled with way more content from my side, because I really would like to fully get back into the YouTube thing. So we have to wait and see. Anyway, thank you for being here. Thank you for spending your time with me, and I hope I will be back soon with another video. Bye.